the message I have for you single guys, because I've met so many single guys who they're trying. They're come to the Philippines and they're looking for a good woman. They're saying, "Man, I just can't find a good girl. I just can't." I asked them, "Well, what's your filtration process? What is your qualifying first priority when you're looking for a woman?" Inevitably, the first criteria is, "Well, she's got to be hot. She's got to be a 9 or a 10, or else I'm just not going to even consider her for a wife." And as much as that may sound right, it's actually it's the wrong foot to start on. It's the wrong direction to go. I do believe, yeah, you want to be attracted to the person you're going to get involved with. You want to be attracted to them. But what I'm saying is don't make that the first priority. Don't make that the first criteria. Is that I'm not even going to ask a girl out unless she really just knocks my socks off. Expand your parameters. She doesn't have to be a 20-year-old knockout 10 model with a perfect body and perfect toned skin and perfect hair and perfect everything. She doesn't have to be that. Open the parameters up, and you'll be amazed how quickly you will find a good woman. Because there are these wonderful women I see every single day. I go into town to run any errand. I see three or four women that I go, man, I wish I knew a guy that's looking for a good woman because there's one right there. And there's another one. Good women that you can tell just have a solid background, come from, a decent family, who have an idea of commitment and loyalty. They're out there working. They're working a job and they're doing the best they can. And you see them deal with little stressful situations and they handle them in a mature way. These are the kind of women that you want to look for. You want to look for character first. And then you find 20 women that have really great character and then pick the prettiest one. Make it the second criteria. And I guarantee you're going to have much better success finding a good woman. Because if the first criteria is only, well, I just got to have the prettiest girl out there. What you're going to end up picking 9 times out of 10 is the girl who, before she left the house, said, I'm going to snag me a man. I'm going to snag me an expat, a foreigner. And she's going to put on her lipstick and she's going to do her aerobics and she's whatever she's going to do. And she's basically going to become what you are looking for. And you're going to fall for it. And it's going to have nothing to do with character. Maybe she has good character, maybe she doesn't. But if she knows that your first criteria is just visual only, you're handicapping yourself. You really are. Which is why I've sat down with so many guys who have said, how can I find a good woman? And I tell them, stay off the dating sites, number one. Get to the Philippines, even if it's only for 2, 3 weeks. Go into the malls, go to the food courts, go anywhere in the public place where there's people and observe. When you see a girl that catches your eye, watch her for 5, 10 minutes from a distance. See what she's like when you're not on her radar. See how she deals with customers. See how she does her work. I'm not saying stalk her, but I'm saying just observe her before you even go say hello. I mean, see again, try to pick up through body language, her mannerisms, everything, what kind of character does she have? Don't make the cover of the book the first criteria. Try to see her character. Try to see how she interacts with other people. Even smiling. Does she smile much? When she's really got nothing on her mind, does she at least have a pleasant look on her face? Often when people are like caught in a daze, that's when you catch kind of like how their mental psyche is. Some people, they just frown. You can just see the negativity in their face. Other people, they're just smiling and happy and energetic no matter what's going on. If you want to find a good woman, expand your parameters. Okay, if she's a little bit pudgy, or she's not as tall as you want, or she's not as short as you want, if her nose isn't perfect, whatever, give the girl a chance. Because in the long run, it's easier to fix all this stuff, get her on aerobics or whatever. It's easier to fix that than to transplant good character into a bad person. And that bad character is what's going to give you drama and problems and heartache later down the road. So here's the summation, finally, of what I'm saying. Look for character in a woman. Look for character. Look for somebody that has a good work ethic, somebody who loves her parents, somebody who's responsible, somebody who's not involved in a massive amount of gossip, somebody who's not easily offended, somebody who has their priorities right. look for some maturity. And you can find that in a hot-looking 20-year-old sometimes. But you're more likely going to find it in a woman that has a bit more experience, life experience. And that could even be into her 30s and 40s. But try not to make the cover of the book the first thing. Just make it the second thing. Look for character first. Then, after you've rounded out maybe five top candidates that you hang out with them and they're fun and you have a good time and all that, then look at, okay, I already know I can have a great time with these women, but now which one am I most attracted to?